Why would Chaitanya Mahaprabhu marry Vishnupriya if he's going to take sannyas? He knows that he's going to take sannyas, but then why did he even marry Vishnupriya in the first place?
Good question. Well, just like Sri Venkateshwara Balaji, Srinivas Govinda, he has two consorts, Bhudevi and Sri Devi. So Lakshmi Priya and Vishnu Priya are those two same consorts. They are both Lakshmi Devi, expansions of Lakshmi Devi. So both of them had appeared and both of them had to become the consorts of Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu. We will see in a few, after a few pastimes, how Lakshmi Priya leaves her body, and then the Lord gets married to Vishnu Priya. And the Lord married Vishnu Priya also to demonstrate how a chaste wife, how she also assists the husband in his mission of serving the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Because remember, this incarnation of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is actually a covered incarnation. It is covered. It is Channa avatar. It is covered. He's not displaying his opulence as the Supreme Lord, but as his own devotee. So when the devotee, as the devotee of the Lord, when the Lord accepted sannyas and left his home, how did Vishnu Priya react to that? How was Vishnu Priya, also staying in touch with Lord Chaitanya by keeping her devotion to him intact? So all that will be described in great detail, but this is a gist of it.
And in this pastime, when he was performing the pastime, he did not know that he is going to take sannyas, that he is going to meet Ishwarapuri and things like that in this pastime. Just like Lord Ramachandra, you could say that if Ramachandra knew that he's going to the forest and that Mother Sita is going to be kidnapped there, why did he even go marry Mother Sita?
Or
He,
take her with him.
or take her with him to the forests. So, yes, these are all the Lord is all knowing, but at the same time, in the pastime that they are performing, it is not known that they know it, that they don't do it knowingly. They're just doing it as a particular pastime, and then eventually it will affect, it comes to pass. So there are different energies of the Lord, and there is the all-knowing energy, and there is the Leela Shakti of the Lord. So the Leela Shakti of the Lord is the one that allows the Lord to continue on his in that particular, in the mood of that pastime. And then he acts as if he does not know. Actually, he
He knows
knows.
everything. Yeah, so even Lord Ramachandra, if Mother Sita would not have been there, then how would Ravana be killed ultimately, if she was not there? So the Lord knows everything, and he planned everything actually. Even, because even the Lord even knew that if Ravana would, touch the actual Mother Sita, that he would be immediately burnt to ashes. So he made sure that he put, Mother Sita under the shelter of Agni Devta, under the fire god, and then Chaya Sita, the shadow Sita, came out. So all these things reveal that the Lord definitely knows all these things are going to happen, but because of the pastime, he takes on that particular mood,
It is described in the Damodar pastime when the Lord was being bound by Mother Yashoda. There were several energies of the Lord who were debating and fighting with each other. There was the Sarvagya Shakti of the Lord, the all-knowing potency. There was the opulent, the Aishwarya
Aishwarya.
Shakti of the Lord, the opulence. And they were saying, how can we allow the Lord to be bound? He is the Supreme Personality. How can he be, how can he accept defeat in this way by just such a small, and so many, everyone was, every Shakti, there were 10 Shaktis who were saying, no, there is no way the Lord can be allowed to be bound. But then there was one Shakti called Kripa Shakti that Kripa Shakti, the Lord allowed the Kripa Shakti to overpower all the other Shaktis in that Damodar pastime. Because he's displaying that, he wants to display that Kripa Shakti, Kripa Shakti's power over all the other Shaktis in different pastimes and different locations. In some locations, he is allowing his opulent Shakti, Aishwarya Shakti, to overpower all the other Shaktis, like when he shows his universal form. Similarly, when he is here with Lakshmi Priya, he is his pastime of love and union with Lakshmi Devi. That Shakti is overpowering all the other Shaktis, even the Sarvagya Shakti of the Lord. And that is just coming up. So different Shaktis just keep coming up in different pastimes as he's displaying. And then that's how the pastimes keep rolling. And then when the Lord was about to take sannyas, yes, that Leela Shakti of the Lord, the Sambhoga Shakti and the of the Lord with Lakshmi Priya, Vishnu Priya was there. But the Kripa Shakti of the Lord overpowered all of that. And out of his compassion for the living entities, he took sannyas. So even though he knows all these things, but there are all these different Shaktis which he's trying to display in different pastimes for the benefit of all